He, remember, just claimed a short while back that he was beaten, he was dragged, and even his mother was abused. Now that ABVP student, who is really the starting point of a controversy that has led to nationwide protests over the last 3 days, he caught up with my colleague Uma Sudhir. She talked to him just a short while back. Let's listen into what he really said.
The university president for the ABVP, Sushil Kumar, who was the original complainant against Rohit and his friends. Sushil, you have been named in this particular FIR, serious charges against you that you abetted his suicide and that you are booked also under the SCST Prevention of Atrocities Act. Are you under hiding, first of all?
I'm not under hiding. In fact, I was under the depression where I could not even digest the fact that Rohit has committed suicide. And to be frank, I'm telling you, Rohit is not a person who will commit suicide so easily. He is the one who confronts anyone, let it be Bandaradatta, let it be Obama, let it be anyone. He used to confront anyone and he used to fight against that. But what made him to commit suicide is even, we are also thinking, and the Supreme Court, the High Court's justice was like 2 days before he was committing suicide. So what made him to go into the depression is a serious question that even we are also raising, and there should be a proper inquiry into that, and the culprit should be punished at any cost. And also, because there are, we feel that, you know, what were these people doing when the Rohit went into such kind of depression? Even like my brother or my friend, if a person is going into the depression, I can easily see that, you know, the person has went into a depression. I can easily understand it through his.
You are saying you have suspicions about the circumstances in which he committed suicide?
Yes, I have so many suspicions, and also I have so many like doubts that has been raising, because I have read that letter for 3 days. I was under depression when people call me criminal. When people blame me saying that I am the reason for Rohit Vemmala's suicide, where he did not mention anything as such in his suicide letter, but I was under depression, I was under a complete shock, and I could not even come out of my room facing anyone.
Going back to August 3-4, you made a complaint. Actually, 2 days later, how many days did it take? At least 2 days later, only admitted yourself in hospital when you said that the group of 40 Ambedkar students, association students assaulted you.
On that night itself, August 3rd night, when I was attacked by these people, August 4th, the unit general secretary has already complained to that. The next day itself, he went and he complained to the university proctorial board, where the university proctorial board has called him, and Krishna Chaitanya, since he wasn't there, he could not provide any hard evidences at that time. And later what has happened is, when I got to know that, you know, the proctorial board has given just a staunch warning to both the groups, I told that there are enough evidences and there are eyewitnesses too, who called me and told that they are ready to come and depose in front of proctorial board. And the unfortunate thing that has happened after me getting hospitalized is the University of Hyderabad Teachers Association has released a poster saying that it was all a fake drama and nothing has happened to me. That is the most depressing part for me also. What is the need for a teachers association to enter into the students' issues? That's the first question. And the second thing is, why they have to release it to the social media? They did not even meet me. They did not even bother about my health concerns. They did not even talk to me.
Even you took 48 hours to get yourself admitted to hospital.
No, that night itself I got admitted into the hospital.
The report seems to suggest that you suffered some shoulder injury, and the appendicitis was not related to your assault itself.
This is the certificate that has been provided by the Achin Hospital where I was got admitted, and blunt trauma abdomen with acute appendicitis is the thing that they have diagnosed. So what does this say again? And what does this say again?
That is, of course, you were operated with appendicitis, which did not have anything to do with the assault.
Who says that? What does this diagnosis mean? The blunt trauma abdomen with acute appendicitis.
BJP MLC Ramchandra Rao said appendicitis had nothing to do with your assault.
BJP MLC Ramchandra Rao, I don't know what he told. I did not even what he told, so I cannot comment on that. But what has happened is, these people started kicking me in my stomach. The person called Vijay, who has kicked me in my stomach, I still remember that. And let's say the appendicitis has happened. Why it has happened only on that day? I mean, only after the attack. Why not before 10 days or before a month, or why not after a month? Why it has happened only that day?
What led to this assault itself? Because you had posted some comments on social media for which you actually offered an apology.
So what has happened is, on August 2nd, I have seen these people doing namaz for Yaqub Miman against the Yaqub Miman's hanging. See, if they protest against the capital punishment, definitely there are arguments, agreements and disagreements. They have did for Afzal Guru, they have did for Vikaruddin, they have did for everything, and we never opposed it. Let us there be a constructive debate on anything. But the statements issuing like, you know, तुम कितने याकूब मारेगे हर घर से याकूब निकलेगा अरे ये याकूब तेरे खून से इनकलाब निकलेगा दिस आई फेल दिस स्टेटमेंट्स आर डिस्टर्बिंग एंड आई वी थॉट ऑफ हैविंग अ प्रोटेस्ट ऑन अगस्ट 4th and we uploaded the posters on Facebook, and it's they are still there on the Facebook. You can download it. And on August 3rd night, these people have come to my room saying that I call them goons. Yes, I told that I call you people goons. Why? Because you people have supported all these activities, and I cannot take my take back my words. If doing something, you can go against the hanging, you can go against the capital punishment, you can have a debate, but doing namaz for certain individual who was found guilty by the Supreme Court itself is not something so simple.
So you put pressure on Bandaru Dattatreya to call them anti-national, to call them extremist, and to say that they are castes?
So one thing you people just tell me, whether the statement "Ek yakum mar gaya to har ghar se yakum nikla" is a pro-national? I don't think so, that it's a pro-national. So obviously when an anti-national activity is done, that should be reported as an anti-national activity. That's the same the Bandaru Dattatreya also repeated. And what he told in the letter, these kind of activities have been taken place in the University of Hyderabad, and Sushil Kumar was attacked. That's all he has written. He did not mention anywhere to intervene and punish the culprits. He asked the MHRD.
He asked for action on your assault, and is that something that you did approach your party leader?
Did anyone find in that letter that he asked for an action on any student? Nothing is written as such, at least in as per my knowledge. Nothing is there. So what the Bandaru Dattatreya has done is he has forwarded the letter that we have submitted to the MHRD, and the MHRD seek the response of the university, and that happens with every student. Let it be anyone whoever approaches the MHRD, they ask the explanation from the university. There are many such cases.
The Cyberabad Commissionerate Police have in fact submitted in court that the injuries that you have spoken about are exaggerated.
I don't know why they spoke about that, or what did they speak about it. I'm not unaware of those facts. In fact, the court given did not agree to give a stay order for these people who got suspended, and the court in fact asked the university to follow the procedures where the university has found these people guilty and they have suspended these people.
Your mother went to court. What is the reason for that? You felt that the police case was not working?
Yeah, it's not about the police case, it's about the pressure that was there on me, because soon after me getting into the hospital, the faculty went against me. They have released a poster. They did not even meet me, and they have released a poster on the social media. And then when my mother went to speak to the vice chancellor of UOH, I can send you the CCTV footages also, where she was also abused, and the vice chancellor, the computer which is there in the vice chancellor cabin, they tried to throw that system on my ABP fellow people. So when there is
why are they all against you? What is the anger against you?
That is the thing. When I oppose these people's activities, and when I got admitted, they thought that there might be some action on them. That's the only reason. So what has happened is, when there is no security for my mother itself, as
you're
a mother,
saying the university teachers and the students all ganged up in a sense against you.
All, not all teachers, but a particular set of teachers who are against the ideology. I felt that, you know, ideologies may differ, but teachers treat us treat everyone of us alike. But that did not happen over there. They went against me. So when there are people, the faculty, the teachers association went against me, and there is no security for my mother itself in the VC cabin, who else should we approach? So we had to approach the government, we had to approach the High Court.
Is there caste discrimination on the campus? Are no. Dalits discriminated against?
No. Whether they are discriminated or not is a debatable issue, because there may be incidents where these people must be discriminated, but that doesn't have any thing to do with this issue. Take this issue as a conflict between two organizations, that's all, but no, do not make it as a Dalit and a non-Dalit issue. I don't know what caste he belongs to, I don't know what caste I belong to. I never reveal my caste. I am from BC category, and I also belongs to the Bahujan category, so these people are suffering. I never wanted to claim all these things, but what I wanted to tell is, do not make it as a Dalit and non-Dalit issue.
Thank you so much.